Hello, welcome to Revelator Alf from RevelatorAlf.com, the channel about motorcycle exploring, biking issues and lifestyle. Please subscribe and hit the notifications bell down there somewhere. So, in this video, I'm basically going to show you a quick tip about video editing using iMovie for your motorcycle videos. And it's also about importing pictures into your video and also extra video which you can use as well. So I'll go onto the screen record and I'll show you there.
Revelator L.
Right, let's get into iMovie then and I'll show you what kind of neat tricks you can do with it. Okay, so this is just biking footage that I had from the other day. Let me just turn the volume down there on that one just a little bit. Just on some really muddy trails. Now let's say I shot this and I thought, you know what, I needed to add a bit of extra commentary on it, or I wanted to do a bit of a face to camera bit. Well, if I just wanted to do commentary, this little icon right here, the little microphone, if you press that, then you press the red button over the particular part of the clip or the movie, the video, you can then actually record a voiceover, basically, if you wanted to do that. Okay, so you get rid of that. But now what I want to do, instead of actually doing a voice recording, I want to introduce extra video, or I want to introduce a photo. So let's say I want to introduce a photo first of all. So there we go, something like that. Right, so oops, I'll do that. This is a photo, there we go. This is the branding of the photo. Now, if I just pop it on top of the timeline here, this is your timeline here of your video. If I just pop it on top, basically what that does, if I let the video run, then as soon as it reaches the photo will take over, but you'll still have the audio beneath it. You see? Like that. And then it'll return back to the audio. Now you can change the time of this, 8 seconds, 10 seconds, whatever, 1 second, whatever you want. Now, if you just click on the upper image of the photo, go to the top here, and you'll see like two squares. Now, cutaway is basically what I've just shown you. But if you go down to picture in picture, or you can have it as a split screen, okay? Well, that doesn't work very well. Or you can have it as picture in picture. And a picture in picture is this. It puts it in the corner. And you can actually move this picture wherever you want. You can resize it as well. So let's say just something like that. So let's say you're doing a face to camera sort of thing and you're talking about a particular bike or whatever. So you can throw up a picture of the bike and you can even point to it, you know, that kind of thing. So this is it. Let's just go back and you'll see what I mean here. There we go. And the picture appears. Now, if you go back into the settings, picture in picture, it's got a dissolve area here. So you can actually change the transition from dissolve to zoom to swap. And you can do change the intro time of that transition. You can put a border on the picture, whatever you want to do. So you can change quite a few effects. They're simple effects, but you can change them. Okay, so that's just a picture. So we'll get rid of that. Now let's say you wanted to put in a video. So let's say right at the start of the video, you think, you know what, I could have done with a little bit of a face to camera piece right here. And you're going over a particular stretch, you want to add another little video face to camera and say, look, it was really tricky here or something like that. So this is a little neat trick. Basically, get onto your webcam or on your iPhone or whatever you want to use and just shoot about 5 or 10 seconds, whatever it is, face to camera, just explaining what you're talking about. So I've already done that here. I've already got them stored in my screen recordings. So this one here, and basically what I'll do is just drag it on top of my timeline, and I'll do the same for the other one. I'll drag it to the top of my timeline. Okay, So let's say this one is a little intro piece, and this is where I'm discussing it a little bit more. So what I want to do, I'm going to start the video, and then I'm going to come in with my own little intro piece. Okay. So that what you can do, you can just split that a little bit, reduce the size of this file. There we go. Probably increase the volume at this point here, and this point here, maybe just bring the volume down a bit so it actually improves the audio quality of that bit. And then you return back to the video. Okay, so that's one bit. That's basically a cutaway. So if you show up here, highlight it, go to the two boxes at the top here, you'll see it's cutaway. That's basically where it just replaces the video and you've got the two audios running at the same time. Or if you don't want any audio on the bass video, then you just reduce the audio all the way down to zero down here. Just click this line and bring it all the way down. Okay, so let's go to a tricky part of the track, and it's getting really muddy. You want to explain that a little bit more. So you can, let's just trim this down a bit. Oops, one didn't want to do that. There we go. Right. That bit, get rid of that. Right. Okay, so this bit, let's say I also want to reduce the volume of the lower track just a little bit, and I want to increase the volume of the top track just a little bit, not too high. There we go. Again, you could have it as a cutaway. Yeah, or you can have it as a pretty neat trick here. So if you go to that two squares at the top, go to the top, go picture in. Now you can either have it as a split screen. I'll show you that first. So there we go. You can play the video and you can then have split screen on the left of you talking and also the actual video footage on the right. So you could do it that way, or you could do it like this. So picture in picture. And then we get very similar to the photo that you had before. So then you can just resize that, put it into a corner, let's say something like that. And then so you can play the footage. There we go. I wasn't here. It was absolutely fine. I'm just lying there. But you get the point. Okay. So you can have different effects, either with the still photos or with video. You can either have it replacing the original video, or you can have it side by side, a split screen, or you can have it inset into the video itself. And it's adjust the volumes as well, play around with it, and it'll work really well. Anyway, so hopefully that's giving you a few ideas how to play around with bits of videos, video clips for your motorcycle videos or any videos that you want to make. Working on a Mac, working with iMovie works really well. It's really simple, really easy to do. And it's quite effective. Yeah, it's pretty basic software, but actually for 99.9% of video editing, I think it's absolutely fine. Right, I hope you found that useful, and it's just one of those things. You've got to keep on playing around with iMovie. It's basic video editing software for a Mac, but actually it works really well, I think, for the most part. It's really good, and once you learn all the little features, you can actually get really good effects from it. Put extra pictures in, extra bits of video as well, and you can actually go back to video that you've shot, whether it's biking videos, riding videos, or whatever it is, and you can just add extra face to camera videos as well. That works really well. All right, catch you on the next video, whenever that is. Please subscribe, hit the notifications bell, leave loads of comments as well, and any tips that you've got. Okay, cheers now.